Dear colleagues, dear conference organizers and participants, I am happy to participate in this conference and thank for inviting me to this conference. And now I will comment briefly my report slides. So my topic is social emotional health of younger school age students in the context of non-crisis. Now, situation in our country is psychologists and teachers working in Lithuanian schools have been encountering increased rates of various dependencies, depression and suicide, bullying, and students' behavioral and emotional problems. According to the UNICEF report of this year, Lithuania ranks 36 out of 38 developed countries in the field of child mental health and 36th place in overall well-being of child. It's very sadness. The research of Lithuanian children conducted this year revealed that the emotional state and the behavior of more than one-third of children deteriorated during the COVID-19 quarantine crisis. So, our research main two objectives. First, to evaluate younger school-age students' social emotional health by following questionnaire primary and to compare the social emotional health among boys and girls. Second, to compare younger school-age students' social emotional health before the crisis. We think about COVID-19 quarantine crisis and during this crisis. Our research refers to students' emotional social health as to a multidimensional construct which encompasses a combination of persons' psychological strengths from the perspective of positive psychology. The current study uses the social emotional health with four strengths dimensions. First, gratitude. Second, optimism. Third, zest and persistence. This is four main dimensions of social emotional health. Gratitude involves being aware of and thankful for good things that happen. The gratitude is positively related with the provision of social support to others, perception of social support received, positive effect, social integration, life satisfaction, and academic achievement. Optimism refers to having a general expectation for good outcomes for the future and promotes self-confidence and perseverance in solving various problems and increases success in achieving the desired goal. Optimism relates with better physical health, recovery from illness, subjective well-being and social engagement, and positive supportive relationships, and high levels of academic success. Zest is defined as approaching life with excitement and energy. Zest has a strong, consistent, positive relationship with health, emotional well-being, autonomy, and positive interpersonal relationships and life satisfaction across all age groups. So, love of learning, gratitude, zest, perseverance to be positively associated with school-related satisfaction. And the last, persistent, has been interpreted in relation with motivation, expectation, effort, and self-regulation. Results of research, Wallet research, suggest that persistence had a strong effect on performance, particularly when there is a perceived lack of competence and interest in the task. Now, about our present research methodology. You see the main tool, social emotional health survey primary. The general index of this survey, called co-vitality, co-vitality maybe correct to say, is measured from 16 items, with 4 items each accessing gratitude, optimism, zest, and persistence. 4 subscales. The general indicator co-vitality is perceived as common personal vitality, activity, and engagement. It is calculating, summing up all the scores of gratitude, optimism, enthusiasm, and persistence subscales. Our psychometric characteristics, the consistency of subscale by Kronbach alpha is from 0.72 to 0.87. So the internal consistency of questionnaire is reliable. Statistical methods you see here in this slide, and maybe you will read carefully. This it is not very special, difficult, I hope, to you. So our next slide about our participants, about our sample. The research was conducted in primary form of Lithuanian schools in January, February 2020, in this year, in the first year days. The research sample included 161 younger school-age students, 83 boys and 78 girls, approximately equal. Now, my note, this study is not yet complete. Data is being collected further. We will provide the first now significant result. And welcome to introduce with our first results. You see in this picture distribution of students according to the gender, boys and girls. And here you see distribution of school age according to normal levels. There are 4 levels by this method. Co-vitality, low, low average, high average, and high. Now, my results is here in the slide. 31.4% of primary school students fell within low and low average level, which shows how vulnerable they are and that they need attention, these school children. The biggest number of respondents are assigned to high and high average level, 68.1%. Which refers to the sufficient resistant. And you will see this in this picture diagram. And we think about what are differences between girls and boys. And so low social emotional health was typical of girls 3 times more often than of boys. This is not okay result. You see in this also picture diagrams here. But comparison of mean ranks of younger school age students' social emotional health indicators according to gender did not reveal any statistically significant differences between the boys and the girls according all 4 scales and general index co-vitality. So you see here results in this table. The data of younger school age students social emotional health in the pre-crisis period, COVID pandemic, quarantine, yes, were compared to the data collected during this crisis. And you see in this table all data. The analysis of manifestations of younger school-age students' social emotional health in the period before the crisis and during it disclose significant differences in the subscales, all main four subscales, with exception of the prosocial behavior scale. By methodology, there is the scale, but we don't use the scale in calculation. The mean ranks of persistence, gratitude, optimism, zest, and general co-vitality index were significantly higher in the period before the crisis, or opposite, in the period of crisis, lower our results, our ranks, compared with the same data before. It's bad result, but it is reality. And also we did correlations. The correlations of moderate strengths and significance were identified between all the questionnaire primary subscales and the general co-vitality index. It's possible to see here in this table. High, average and high correlations. So, conclusions. First, there are no gender differences in general social emotional health index co-vitality and subscales. This aligns with the study of Farlung on the development of the same methodology tools, elementary, where all the subscales showed full factor invariance across genders. Second conclusion, research disclosed deterioration of young school-age students' social-emotional health subscales during crisis of COVID-19 quarantine. And this is coincided with many other results of other researchers who use other tools in COVID quarantine period. And third, the conducted and the analysis of questionnaire subscales revealed positive relationships of average and high significance, what allows for preliminary evaluation of this tool, social emotional health primary questionnaire, yes, construct and appropriate research instrument for investigation of younger school-age student health. The received data partially coincide with the results of other authors. For example, gratitude was found to have stronger relationship with the other positive psychological constructs, school engagement, and young people's well-being. So, this is first preliminary three results, and our future research you see here in this slide. To form a larger and more representative sample of Lithuanian primary school students. Second, to compare social emotional health of younger school age students with the life satisfaction and school climate. Third, to apply the version adapted for Lithuania in monitoring the social emotional health primary school students. And fourth, being able to access the strengths and weaknesses of students may be more effective in predicting adaptation within distance learning during crises and different concrete social contexts. So we now working in this field, and I hope we will do all these tasks, all this our future yes, tasks, our this concrete research. That was the last our slide. And so thank you for all, and Jakuyam. Now.